Hi all, welcome to Shankar AIS Academy's Daily Editorial Analysis, 18th November 2024. Pre-storming UPSC Prelims Test Series 2025, Batch 3 starts from 21st November 2024. If you want to join this test series, click the link given below in the description and enroll yourself. The another one is Chakra Initiative of Shankar AIS Academy, which is complete coverage of current affairs with exclusive 50 plus classes and 8 plus current affairs based test. If you want to know more about this program, see the brochure which is linked in the description. Without any delay, let's see the list of editorials from two different newspapers. The first editorial, which is taken from the Indian Express, this editorial talks about role of artificial intelligence in governance. The second editorial, which is taken from the Hindu newspaper, which talks about two cheers for the top court's bulldozer judgments. This editorial talks about bulldozer demolitions, public protest against it. Without any delay, let's get into the editorial analysis. Look at this editorial, which speaks about Supreme Court of India criticized the use of demolition as a form of bulldozer justice, where authorities demolished homes of individuals accused of offences without due legal process. The court emphasizes that no one's home should be demolished simply because of an accusation or even a conviction without proper legal jurisdiction. With the Supreme Court's judgment, let's see the background of this case. The rise of bulldozer justice, that is, the Supreme Court of India's decision on bulldozer justice, is an important step in protecting constitutional principle and the rule of law. In recent years, there have been many cases where authorities in different parts of India have demolished homes often during communal tensions or large protests. These demolitions were sometimes supported and praised by politicians, raising worries about unfair action and abuse of power by the states. Let's see the judgment of Supreme Court in detail. Violation of rule of law. The court said that demolition carried out as retribution violated the fundamental aspects of the rule of law and constitutional safeguards. It emphasizes that the executive's action had turned into a vigilant form of justice, where the state assumed the role of judge, jury and executionary. And the second one is protection of right. Homes cannot be demolished based on accusation without due legal process. And also Supreme Court introduced some of the guidelines to the demolitions. They are clear jurisdictions required for demolition, adherence to legal processes mandate, and authorities cannot justify like irregular constructions without adhering to the rule of. With this information, let's move on to the key legal and constitutional principle interventions. Due process of law, that is Article 21. The judgment reinforced that Article 21 of the Indian Constitution, which guaranteed the right to life and personal liberty, includes the right to shelter also. Demolishing homes without following due processes violates the fundamental rights under Article 21. The second one is separation of power, which advocated that the executive actions were encroaching upon judicial functions. By demolishing homes based on the mere accusation, the state overstepped its bounds, acting both as an accuser and a punisher. Proportionality principle. This principle requires that any state action must be necessary and appropriate. The Supreme Court's judgment clarified that demolitions could only be justified if they were proportional to the situation, not as a method of punishments. With this legal actions, let's see the implications of the judgment. Accountability of state officials. The judgment suggested that state officials could be held personally liable for unlawful demolitions. This introduces a significant measure to prevent misuse and ensure that decisions are made transparently. The second one is preventing arbitrary action. This ruling aims to ensure that vulnerable communities are not targeted under the pretext or irregular constructions. It established safeguards that prevent authorities from using demolitions as a tool for political or communal retaliation. Introducing balanced approach to urban planning. The judgment pushes for a structured and reasonable approach to urban planning and enforcement. It asserts that while unauthorized constructions can be dealt with under the law, this action should not become a means of exerting undue pressure or punishment. With this, let's see the challenges and further considerations regarding this case. Despite of the judgment, challenges remain regarding the practical implication of these guidelines. training needed. Authorities need to balance enforcing construction laws with respecting constitutional rights. Checks and balances. It is crucial for states to train officials on this new guidelines and establish checks and balances to avoid selective or politically motivated enforcements. So, on behalf of this case, the Supreme Court's judgment on bulldozer justice sends a strong message reinforcing the importance of the rule of law, due process and the protection of individual rights. It serves as a reminder that the power of the state must be exercised within the bounds of constitutional principles, ensuring justice and fairness in every action. With this knowledge of this editorial, try to answer the main question. Examine the impact of state-led demolitions in the context of communal tension or protest in India. Without any delay, let's move on to the next editorial. Look at this article which talks about artificial intelligence in governance. This editorial discusses the India's transformative governance journey over the last decade driven by digital public infrastructure involved with artificial intelligence. In this light of editorial, let's see what is artificial intelligence, how artificial intelligence improve efficiency and effectiveness in governance of India. Artificial intelligence refers to the stimulation of human intelligence in machine programmed to think, reason, learn and act. It encompasses a wide range of technology such as machine learning, natural language processing and computer vision. And also it operates based on the algorithm that enables system to process data, draw insights and perform tasks with minimal human interference. With this, let's move on to the applications of AI in governance. Applications of AI in governance can be categorized into several subdivisions. Let's see one by one. Policy design and implementation. AI-driven data analysis improves the precision of policy decision by identifying socio-economic patterns. Tools like large language models assist in drafting and revising laws and regulations effectively. Public service delivery. It facilitates direct benefit transfers to reduce leakage and enhance transparency. For example, AI used in Arogya Sedu app for COVID-19 tracking. Economic management. Optimizes the tax collection and monitor revenue leakages, and also forecasting supports in budget planning and allocation. Healthcare facilities. It predicts models for epidemic control and diagnostics, and also accelerates drug discovery through data analytics. In agriculture, tools like Kisan Suvidha app provide crop advisory and weather updates, which supports soil quality assessment and precision farming. Climate change and disaster management, which predicts natural disaster and develop early warning system, which can enhance climate models for accurate planning according to the weather condition. Next, we are going to see about cyber security and national security. It secures digital infrastructure by detecting threats in real time. AI also enhances surveillances for law enforcement in India. Language translation. AI-driven platform improves access to government services in local languages. For example, NLP used in Voice of India project. After knowing these applications of AI, let's see the advantages of artificial intelligence in governance. Efficiency and accuracy. It improves efficiency through automates tasks, reducing error and delays. Cost saving. Lower administrative costs through automations. Predictive capability. Anticipates issues like health outbreak and economic trends. Corruption reduction directly links benefits to recipients, which minimizes the intermediaries. Inclusivity. Its tailored solution improves accessibility to services with the help of algorithm and artificial intelligence. Even though artificial intelligence in governance has many advantages, there are some disadvantages. Let's see what are they. Disadvantages of AI governance can be listed out in 5 forms. They are data privacy concern, bias and inequality, digital divide, dependence on private entities and unemployment risk. Let's see in detail about one by one. Data privacy concern, which talks about risk related to misuse of sensitive and personal data in public forum. The second is bias and inequality. Algorithms may practice biased and unequal data segregations. It may lead to inequality in society. Digital divide, which excludes those without internet access or without having literacy in digital. Digital divide excludes those without internet access or without having literacy in digital usage. dependency on private entities. It explains about over reliance on tech firms may challenge accountability and efficiency of government. Unemployment risk. Because of AI's technology, minimal interference of human will lead to the unemployment in manual sectors. To resolve this disadvantages of artificial intelligence in governance, let's see some of the way forward measures. Strengthen legal framework. Enforce stringent data protection laws like Digital Personal Data Protection Act 2023. And develop ethical guidelines for artificial intelligence implementation in governance. Upskilling workforce, which means training public officials on artificial intelligence usage. Inclusive digital ecosystem, which promotes digital literacy to bridge the digital divide between literate digital users and illiterate digital users. Support for AI innovation, government funding for AI research and startups under the India AI program. Collaboration, partnership with global partnership on AI and tech entities for expertise sharing. Localized solution, which focusing on region-specific AI applications, particularly in rural healthcare facilities, agriculture and disaster management to prevent rural population from vulnerability. Transparency and accountability, which ensures that artificial intelligence algorithms are auditable and explainable to prevent misuses or bias in the society. From the knowledge of this editorial, try to write the main answer. Artificial intelligence has the potential to revolutionize governance in India, but it also possesses significant challenges. Critically evaluate the role of artificial intelligence in enhancing governance and the measures needed for its effective implementation. I have another one important announcement from Shankar AIS Academy, which is regarding current affairs monthly marathon, which is posted eventually second week of every month in our YouTube channel. Do check it, which is completely reliant on upcoming preliminary examination. With this, we come to the conclusion. If you like this video, hit the like button, do comment and share the video to your friends. Don't forget to subscribe this channel. Thank you for watching.